In this video, you'll find out how a microphone works. We'll also talk about the two main types of microphones for recording, dynamic and condenser. You'll also find out why they're not good listeners. Hi, I'm Aviva from the LEWITT channel. So, how does a microphone work? Every microphone follows the same principle. Sound waves hit a membrane and make it move according to the source. The energy of the sound wave needs to be converted into an electrical signal or voltage, and there are different ways of doing this. So, when I start speaking, I create sound waves. The sound waves then hit the membrane of the microphone. The microphone converts this movement into an electrical signal that we can now use for different purposes, such as recording, communication, and for amplifying things like our voices or instruments. In this video, we will focus on dynamic and condenser microphones for recording purposes. Of course, there are other types of microphones as well, but they're not as commonly used for recording. Dynamic microphones are often used in loud environments, and I'm actually speaking into one right now. Condenser microphones are used for detailed recordings, and we'll find out why in a minute. Let us know in the comments how they compare in terms of sound. Dynamic microphones are mainly front-addressed, meaning that we need to point the mic towards its source, like this. This is a typical dynamic handheld microphone that you may often see used by singers on stage. Under the mesh sits a capsule and its membrane. You see this foil here? That's it. That's the membrane. A dynamic microphone has a pretty robust capsule. The back of the membrane is attached to a coil of wire. Both the diaphragm and the coil move back and forth according to incoming sound waves. The coil is placed inside of a magnetic field, and when it moves, an electrical signal is induced. If you think about it, it may kind of remind you of the way that a loudspeaker works. And that's because they actually both function with the same acoustic principle. You could even say that a dynamic microphone is a reversed loudspeaker. Dynamic microphones are extremely sturdy. They're often used for loud sources like guitar cabinets, snare and kick drums, and for loud stage environments in general. Condenser microphones are mostly used to create detailed recordings in the studio. There are condenser mics with small diaphragms, and there are condenser mics with large diaphragms. You may often see these ones in the studio when recording vocals. They are mostly side-addressed. Small diaphragm condenser mics are also known as pencil mics because of their form. They are perfect for recording acoustic instruments and are front-addressed. Let's check out how a condenser microphone works. It doesn't matter if it's a small or large diaphragm condenser, both work the same. This is a large diaphragm condenser mic. Let's remove the mesh and see what's inside. P.S. Don't try this at home. Okay, so this is the capsule, and here what you can see is the membrane. It's extremely thin and light, and therefore reacts very accurately to sound. That's why condenser mics sound so detailed. The membrane is electrically charged, and behind it sits a fixed backplate. Together, the membrane and the backplate form a capacitor. When the sound hits the membrane, the capacitance changes, and with the help of the internal electronics, condenser microphones can convert this change in capacitance into an electrical signal. All condenser microphones need power to make their internal electronics work. For professional mics, this is called phantom power. It's 48 volts and comes from an audio interface or mixing console. So, when do we use these types of mics? Well, small diaphragm condenser mics are perfect for acoustic instruments like guitars or strings. Large diaphragm condenser mics are a typical choice when recording studio vocals. I'm the pawn at a dungeon, I am me. And now, the shocking truth. Microphones can't hear.
What?
Yes, you heard me correctly. Hearing is more than just receiving sound waves. It also includes selective attention in the auditory system. This is what we refer to as the cocktail party effect. Imagine you're at a party. And you're having a conversation. Oh, yeah. you know, there's a vibe, some music in the background. There are also other people having conversation, ambient noises, and so on. With all of this going on at once, how is it possible that you're still able to focus on the conversation that you're having? Well, this is possible because your brain is able to tune out to sounds that it does not want to focus on, meaning that you actually hear selectively. A microphone cannot do that. It doesn't have the capability to select its attention. That's why you always have to pay attention to the noises around you before you hit the record button or start streaming your channel. Train your ears to work like a microphone and pick up everything you can. Become the microphone, and you'll immediately improve the quality of your recordings. Check for noise you don't usually pay attention to. Noise coming from outside. Others around you. The air conditioning. Your computer. Your annoying neighbor. Your girlfriend's high heels. Or your boyfriend's high heels. Or your drummer. Just remember, it's not about having the perfect gear or environment, but making the most out of what you have. If you have any questions, please let us know in the comments section. You can also let us know what you would like us to cover in the future. Subscribe and hit the like button if you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and until next time, make yourself heard.